Now to politics. Come 19 September, Edo State will go to the polls to elect a governor to pilot the affairs of the state for the next 4 years. National Chairman of the Caretaker Committee of the All Progressives Congress, May Malabuni, has inaugurated the 49-member council for the governorship election in Edo State. The campaign team, headed by the governor of Kano State, Abdullahi Ganduje, is expected to start off immediately. Well, joining me via Skype is Governor of Kano State and the Chairman APC Edo Campaign Council, Abdullahi Ganduje. Yes, Excellency, thank you for joining us on the news this afternoon.
Thank you. Thank you very much for inviting me as well. Thank you.
All right, let's begin with a video making the rounds where you made a statement saying that you will isolate Governor Wike, win Edo governorship election before he recovers. Would like for you to expatiate on that. How do you mean?
Thank you very much. It's a political statement showing that politically we are going to cage him because he has nothing to tell the people of Edo State, considering the administration of the present Governor Obaseki, who has just crossed to their own party. So we mean that actually he has nothing to tell the people of Edo State, and we will shut him down because we have facts and figures about the administration of Obaseki, who abandoned his party and joined a new party simply because he wants to contest and disregarding the state of affairs of Edo State.
Talking about abandoning parties, you would recall that in 2016, it seems there is a shift on both sides. And there is a statement you also made with regards to this, saying that the PDP accommodated Governor Obaseki because they want to have access to the state's treasury. And the question is, on what grounds did the APC accommodate Izeyamu, who was of the PDP in 2016?
Well, you see, if you look at the situation is quite different because the pastor Osagi Iyamo was not in the same circumstance as Mr. Obaseki in this time around. Mr. Obaseki was voted 2016 by the people of Edo State, and then backed by our national chairman, Comrade Adam Ashomule, but he took a lot of time with infight instead of paying attention to the governance of the state. But the other case you are referring to is not the same as this one. So you can see that a lot of time was wasted with litigations, infight, and at the expense of governance, and at the end of it, he has crossed to another party.
So now, some might say that the incumbent governor defecting to the PDP might be of advantage to the PDP now, looking at the power of incumbency. I wonder how would you react to that statement.
Well, I think that is anticipated because the real issue is that the people of Edo State, who have been abandoned in terms of good governance, who have been cheated, they are watching. So it is a miscalculation to say that the incumbency will, you know, provide dividends as far as this election is concerned. If you look at it, the art of governance is to provide, you know, infrastructure facilities, social economic development, peace and stability in the state. But if you look at it, all these things are lacking not because there was no enough fund provided from the federal government and the internally generated revenue to some extent, but simply because there was no peace of mind, and the governor himself was always thinking of, you know, fighting his perceived opponents. And because of that, he spent a lot of money on litigation, on lawyers, on court processes. And we have learned that he had about 53 cases in the court. And you can imagine how much money has been spent on that. But what is even important, what has he on the ground in order to convince the people of Edo State that he should be voted again?
So how do you intend to sell your candidate differently to the people of Edo State, since his emergence seems to appear to be on a different platform now? Like I mentioned earlier, he was on the platform of the PDP in 2016, and now he is with the APC.
Yes, he was on the platform of PDP during the last gubernatorial election 2016, and he was marginally defeated. And the advantage now, he has come over with most of his followers, most of his admirers, while Obaseki has gone not much with the followers, but only with the members of the cabinet, because of the injustice that he has committed, especially if you look at the legislators who won their election, who were voted by their people, but he refused to swear them in so that they can take part in democracy in Edo State themselves, and those who voted them are not happy at all, and they are bound not to vote for him again. So you can see that our own candidate is a man of God, is a man who is known in the train, is a man who is honest, and is a man who is keeping to his promise. I am sure if he wins the election, he will not behave like Obaseki, who slapped the man who put him there with the help of the people of Edo State.
Your Excellency, Governor Abdullahi Ganduje, thank you for your time on the news.